for sure. All right. Well, in Fox 5 Health News, concerns over a treatment for a deadly superbug.
Joining us now is Dr. Zankhana Raval from Holy Name Medical Center. This is even more frightening.
Yeah, and we're burying the lead here. This is that fecal transplant thing, which
was
wild when we heard about it the first time.
Exactly. We called it the poop pill. Everyone remembers the headline,
right? So explain what it was and why we're now not into it.
So the FDA has recently had to halt several clinical trials because, unfortunately, there were two recipients of fecal transplants that were transplanted, unfortunately, ESBL, which is a very drug-resistant E. coli bacteria. And in their frail state, unfortunately, this became not only a bad infection, but it was fatal. So let's take a step back, right? Everyone's thinking, what the heck is a fecal transplant,
exactly,
if they're not familiar with it. I mean, we all have this idea of probiotics, right? We all have healthy bacteria in our gut. And unfortunately, with either what we're eating or infections and having to take antibiotics, if the natural balance of bacteria in the gut is disturbed, then harmful bacteria can take over. And so in that situation, people who have bad bacteria take over, we have to treat them with antibiotics, and that can fuel a cycle. So there are certain situations, for example, people who have C. diff, which is a very potentially deadly infection of the gut, need broad-spectrum antibiotics, and then we have to restore the balance somehow. And in certain situations, just eating healthy and taking probiotics is not enough. And so this idea of taking healthy bacteria from healthy donors, healthy people, so the actual bacteria from the stool
would then flourish in the recipient's gut. That was the thought on this whole thing.
Exactly.
Now they're
and so, you know, it's a biologic, so it's an investigational new drug, which means that it has to go through the entire FDA process. And it's going through that process, so anytime that something like this happens, you know, it is still considered a clinical trial, and it affects the progress of the clinical trials.
Gotcha. All right.
Well, aside from the salt, sugar, and fat, is there something else going on with processed food that makes it so hard to resist? I would think so, but you can tell us.
I think we all know this, right? It's easy on the taste buds, and it's easy on the wallet. You know, this is a science. There's a lot of industrial process that goes into making it the
right. It's not accidental. They figure out how to make sure if you have one chip, you eat the whole bag.
You're going to eat the whole bag. So there actually was a small study that they did saying, okay, how does this actually affect people? It's not rocket science, but on average, people ate about 500 calories more, and you're going to eat faster. The texture, the taste, everything is good, right? It's good for, it's considered junk food for a reason.
It used to be hard to get calories, and now it's not, and that's
unfortunately
the evolutionary problem we're in. Right, exactly.
Not at all.
All right, Dr. Zankhana Raval, we appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Thank you. All right.